हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। एंड टुडे वी विल कवर अ डिफरेंट टॉपिक। वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ भवत भवम इन वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजी। सो भवत भवम इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट इन वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजी। ओम श्री रामाय नमः। सो भवत भवम इज ऑलवेज कैलक्युलेटेड for a particular house in Vedic astrology. So it is like first from the first house, that is the Bhavat Bhavam of the first house. Second from the second house, that is the Bhavat Bhavam of the second house. Third from the third house, that is the Bhavat Bhavam of the third house. Fourth from the fourth house, that is the Bhavat Bhavam of the fourth house. And so on. 12th from the 12th house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 12th house. But what exactly is this Bhavat Bhavam? Let us see that. So let us consider, for example, the 5th house and calculate the Bhavat Bhavam of the 5th house, which means I have to count 5 from the 5th house, okay, including the 5th house. So let us start. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I reach the 9th house. So Bhavat Bhavam of the 5th house is nothing but the 9th house. What does this mean? What is the 5th house all about? Okay, 5th house is all about your Punya Karma in the past life. Okay, it is about your children. It is about love. It is about romance. Okay, and what is the 9th house about? The 9th house is all about dharma. It is about spirituality. Okay, so the highest results of the 5th house manifest in the 9th house. Why do I say this? Because 5th house represents love, and 9th house represents the highest dimension of love, that is the love for God, the love for dharma. And therefore, the results of the 5th house, they manifest maximum in the 9th house. So the reality is that the 9th house is actually a reflection of the results of the 5th house, and therefore it is known as the Bhavat Bhavam of the 5th house. Now let us see the Bhavat Bhavam of the 9th house. Okay, so count 9 from the 9th house, including the 9th house. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You reach the 5th house. So the Bhavat Bhavam of the 9th house is nothing but the 5th house. Now why is this so? The 9th house again is about dharma, spirituality, truth. Okay. And the 5th house is about love and knowledge. So the highest knowledge or the highest love is the love for God, and the highest knowledge is also the knowledge about the divine, the supreme being. And therefore the results of the 9th house, they truly manifest via the 5th house, and the 5th house is thus a reflection of the 9th house. And therefore the 5th house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 9th house. The 5th house is also the Bhavat Bhavam of the 3rd house. Why do I say this? Count 3 from the 3rd house. So 3, 4, 5. Again, you reach the 5th house. Now, why is the 5th house the Bhavat Bhavam of the 3rd house? The 5th house is about Purva Punya Karma. The 3rd house is about your siblings, your relations, your neighbors, and the efforts you put. Okay, so if your efforts are sincere, if your relations are sincere, they will manifest in the form of true love in your relationship. And therefore, the 5th house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 3rd house and the 9th house. Now, what is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 10th house? Okay, the 10th from the 10th house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 10th house. So, start counting. 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You reach the 7th house. So actually the Bhavat Bhavam of the 10th house is the 7th house. Why is this so? Now, what is the 10th house all about? 10th house is about your career, your profession, your status and recognition in society. Okay? And 7th house is all about partnerships. It is about relationship. Right? Now, let us say you win an award. Okay? Will you be happy if nobody congratulates you and you win that award? Will you really feel happy? No. Okay? So you need some kind of recognition for that award. You want somebody to come and congratulate you, or you yourself want to feel good. Okay? You want your relationships to appreciate you. Now, where do you get this appreciation from? Okay? You have to get it from the 7th house. That is the house of your partnerships, the house of your relationships. And therefore, the results of the 10th house reflect truly in the 7th house. And therefore, the 7th house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 10th house. Let us take one more example. Let us calculate the Bhavat Bhavam of the 8th house. So, what is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 8th house? It is the 8th from the 8th house, including the 8th house. Okay. So, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. I reach the 3rd house. Now, what does this mean? What is the 8th house all about? The 8th house is about sudden upheavals. Okay. It is about sudden changes in your life. It is about your longevity. It is also about occult science and accidents. And what is the 3rd house about? The 3rd house is about your siblings. It is about the efforts that you put in your life. Okay? It is also called the house of preaching. Alright? And therefore, for your longevity, the 3rd house is also a very important house. That is, the 3rd house is actually a reflection of the effects of the 8th house. So longevity of a person is also determined not just from the 8th house, but you also need to look at the 3rd house. Now let us look at one last example. What do you think is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 1st house? The Bhavat Bhavam of the 1st house is the first from the 1st house, including the 1st house. So it is the 1st house itself. You yourself are a true reflection of yourself, right? So Bhavat Bhavam of the 1st house is the 1st house itself. If you are not there, the question of your reflection existing does not arise. Now, what is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 7th house? The 7th house is your life partner, correct? What is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 7th house? Count 7 from the 7th house. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1. Okay. So the 1st house is the Bhavat Bhavam of the 7th house. What does this mean? It is your partner, your life partner who makes you complete. Okay. Your life attains a true meaning once you get a proper partner in your life. And therefore, the Bhavat Bhavam of the 7th house is the 1st house. So Bhavat Bhavam of a particular house is a reflection of the true manifestation of the results of that house. And this is in short the concept of Bhavat Bhavam in Vedic astrology. So if you like this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. If you are not subscribed to our channel, Kamath Astrology, you can do so by clicking the subscribe button. For any queries, email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com and we'll be glad to assist you. You can reach us also through our website astroseva.tripod.com or by downloading our mobile application Kamath Astrology from Google Play Store. So friends, thanks a lot. We'll see you shortly with another video. Till then, take care, stay home, stay safe, bye.